We would rather have won the game, but you've always got to respect every point away from home. And like we said at the end of the game, Barra's always a tough place to go. Me personally, I've never got much up there over the years. It's always a difficult place to go. You made to work very hard to get anything there. So to come away with a point under the circumstances, getting a goal late, yeah, we're pleased. But probably over the course of the game, we're disappointed we didn't take all three.
And in terms of where you are now in the league as we go into the new year, are you happy might not be the right word, but are you content with where you are at the moment in terms of making a run for it in the closing months of the season?
Yeah, I think we've got ourselves in a good position to go and attack a good finish. We take every step as it comes and work hard every day in training and keep trying to improve, as we say all the time. But certainly there's been a lot of good work going over the last sort of, I think it's sort of 17 games, we've lost two, I think, something like that. So we're heading in the right direction. Still want to make major improvements and keep winning games and keep improving our team. But the lads are all rowing in the same direction, so we're pleased at the minute.
I saw some quotes from the Edge League manager this week regarding James Alabi moving down there. Are you able to clarify what the situation is with him?
It's a wee bit on and off, I think. I think as we sit here, right this minute in time, it's not going to happen. So until really I know anything more concrete than that, that's really all I can say. He's still at Dover. I think maybe, I don't know, Ipswich maybe jumped the gun in that before they actually had anything agreed. But I really don't know. It's not really been something that I've been dealing with personally. I just sort of hear probably as much as we used it at a certain point, and then I've heard in the last sort of half an hour that maybe something isn't happening, but that could change again just as quickly.
Why do you think it hasn't quite worked out for him here yet?
It's difficult to say because he is a very coveted player at our level, as you know, all the top teams in the league are after James. I think it's the old, I keep saying it, and I don't want to bore people with it, but it's more difficult to play for Tranmere than play against Tranmere. The standards are very high. The crowd are very, very demanding. If you don't hit the numbers and hit their levels of performance or do what your job is, it's a club that at this level won't really hang about and wait for you. You have to really perform, as all the players here will tell you. So maybe you don't get as much opportunity here, game after game after game, to try and ease yourself into having any kind of career. You have to hit the ground running, and when you don't do that, it becomes very, very difficult, as we've seen in the past. The boys that have been playing have done very well, so that's not opened up many opportunities for many people outside of the group. It's just football, it's just the way it goes. The first 11 are doing well, then it's very difficult to break that down.
And in terms of players that are here and maybe you're looking to get back, are any of them any closer to returning?
Getting closer all the time, but won't be available this weekend. Stepping up their training, I think James Wallace will go into full contact, full hit from Monday onwards, so he'll return to the group. And we hope that he gets a slice of good fortune, because he certainly deserves that. Scott Davis is progressing, and Ben Tollett is progressing quickly as well. Probably, but maybe, I don't really like to put dates on it, but I know everybody will be, I'm sort of the person that puts forward the information that everybody wants to know. But I think we'll be looking at all things going well, Ben being available towards the end of the month.
And those are the kind of players that give you a huge boost, huge difference to get those guys back.
Tollett's, in my opinion, the best player in the league. I don't think there's any question about that. I mean, best player in the league, but he's the player that makes the most impact for me in the division. So he's been a huge, huge loss. James Wallace, he's been a massive loss. James Wallace is for every part of him a championship player who could handle playing in the championship against anybody every week. Injuries have held him back bad fortune. So you lose the types of players, and Scott Davis is, without a shadow of a doubt, in my opinion, comfortably the best goalkeeper in the league. So to lose these kind of players is always going to have an impact, and to lose Ollie Banks as well has had an impact as well. But what we've all said is we have got other good players here, very, very good players, who will come in now and keep to try and move the thing forward, because that's what clubs at Tranmere have, is good footballers. But certainly losing Toller, I think we could highlight that one as when we did have an impact on the club.
It appears from what Oldham have said that they will be willing to let Banks leave the club permanently. Is that something that you might look at?
Ollie Banks won't be coming back to Tranmere. He's had a conversation with him a couple of days ago. The conversation went that he wanted to get, if possible, a league club closer to where he lives. I think we've got some news today that he has got a league club that isn't closer to where he lives, but he's got himself a league club, so he won't be coming back to Tranmere. So we were always prepared. We've got good players with Jeff Hughes and Jay Harris, who are very, very good players, and Ollie Norburn, very good midfield players. So it's not an area that of the pitch that we're weak in anyway. So we'll just move ahead with that now and try and adjust and adapt and try and freshen things up if possible over the next 24 hours. We might have some news and getting a new face into the group. So we'll, like I always say, I'm not trying to be a cloak and dagger. I just want to make sure that when I do get these news that it's concrete, but one's very close.
And as I understand it, there's some interest in Eddie Clark from Wigan. Is that a move that could happen as well?
I don't know. Eddie will be with us at the weekend. So, no, it won't be happening. Football moves so fast, and then you think something may happen and it doesn't. So, this minute in time, the entire group will be here for the weekend, and I can be 100% honest, because as I said, I'm going to communicate with Tranmere fans through you guys 100%. I haven't been told any different that anybody's going to be leaving, and I would hopefully believe that I would be the one who would know around about first. So absolutely 100%, they boys will be here tomorrow for training and start this game.
Massive game, obviously, the weekend. What are your thoughts looking ahead to Saturday?
It's huge. It's a great opportunity for us because there's not many games in our league. The games are Saturday now, so you want to try and get your players refreshed and well prepared for the games in between with the rest that we'll be able to get now. It's a huge game because it's an opportunity to keep pecking away and trying to get up the league table. It gives us an opportunity to jump in a few places, there's no doubt about that. Woken up and doing very well. They're a good football team. It gave us a good game of football the last time that we played them, and we scored some good goals to get a victory. They're well capable of, if you allow them, to go toe-to-toe with any team in this league. So we'll go down there, and we know that the value of the 3 points, we'll try to do everything we possibly can to keep together the form that we have at the minute and try and get another massively important 3 points.
Any other fresh injuries from Saturday?
No, we are okay. Buckle was trained today, so he's back, and I think that was the only one that came out of the game with the weekend. Everybody else, we're just keeping them fit and happy, and we just keep moving forward.